Look at him extra hard.
Here we go. Okay, so yesterday we talked about plane mirrors, flat mirrors. We're going to talk now about curvy mirrors. Okay, specifically spherical mirrors. So you take a sphere. And you play a fruit ninja. Okay. So if it's, you get two different types. You get a convex mirror and you have a concave mirror. Well, I remember the difference. Concave, you're going into a cave. Okay. Convex, you're flexing. So you get a bulge, vex, flex. See the bulge. Okay, that's how I remember it. Now, a little bit of geometry. So you got the center of that sphere, you have a certain radius. The focal point is halfway between, is half of the radius. Okay, look at that. Okay. What's so special about a focal point? Well, when you have parallel rays coming in, they're going to reflect to a focal point. Okay? Good with that? That's why we have a focal point. So the center of that's going to be like right there. All right. So if you are note type taking people, you probably want to get out multiple colors. If you have multiple colors, if you don't, it's fine. When we draw in ray diagrams. So while you get those out, some applications of this would be like radar dishes. This is the focal point. This is just crazy concept like solar power making power generation. So these plane mirrors rotate and tilt and reflect their sunbeams to the center post here, heats that up, boils water, sends steam through turbines, and produces electricity. This is a proof of concept. We don't do more of these because it's just a whole lot of work, a whole lot of resources, and it's not really worth it. But one example of renewable energy. So, here's what we've got. You're going to draw, this line here is called the principal axis. This is the principal axis. Okay. This is going to be your object. Your center. So this is like a sector of your circle. Center. And then half the distance between your center and the mirror, you can put your focal point. The better you draw that to scale, the better your results are going to be.
What is that?
Focal point.
But where is it?
Halfway between the center point and the mirror. Okay. All right. Draw your object past the center point. You're going to give me a thumbs up when you're good to go. We're going down the physics road today. See, is the center of that circle.
Sorry, it's not there, so I didn't know.
It's the center as if the circle was there. This center.
Oh, it's that thing.
That center.
I mean, not really.
Okay. All right. Here we go. Don't draw this. So we're looking at the object. The object reflects light off of it. It reflects light off in all directions. Don't draw this. Okay. In all directions. Some of those rays hit the mirror. Some of them don't. I just care about three specific rays. Okay. And those three, this is what you want to draw. Your first ray, you're always starting at the top of the object. Your first ray is going to go parallel to the principal axis. Parallel to the principal axis.
Are we still not drawing this?
You draw this. Do you draw this? Draw parallel to the principal axis. And tell your neighbor how that's going to reflect. Like, where's that going to go once it hits the mirror? How's it going to reflect? Okay, ready? Gonna go to the focal point. Okay, so it's gonna reflect through the focal point. Having a straight edge doing this would be beneficial. Reflects through the focal point. Okay. Good at that. That's the first ray. Before we do the second ray, let's reflect on this. If we took a ray of light and went through the focal point, how is it going to reflect? If we took a ray of light and we shined it through the focal point, how is that ray going to reflect through the focal point? Remember this idea, like if you can see someone in the mirror, they can see you. Okay. It's going to reflect parallel. It's going to reverse that path. You good with that? Okay. So we're going to use this idea and say, well, let's take a ray of light that goes through the focal point, but let's start at the top of the object. One of those rays that are coming from the top of the object is going to go through the focal point. And so when it does, and it hits the mirror, it's going to reflect how? Parallel to the principal axis. Yeesh. Okay. Because it's not going parallel. Only rays that go parallel to the principal axis reflect to the focal point.
Will there always be a parallel
one? Yes. That'll be your first one. Okay. Here's that. And then the third one, we're going to do a little bit of geometry review before we got a circle with a radius, a line that is tangent to the circle. how does the radius and the tangent line intersect? Like, what's the angle? It is perpendicular, okay? When you, let's say you have a mirror and you shine a light straight onto it, how's that going to reflect? It's going to reflect right back. So if it's perpendicular, it's going to reflect right back to it. Good with that? So we're going to use those two ideas. And we're going to start here at the top, and we're going to go through the center. When it hits there, it should hit straight on to the mirror and therefore reflect straight on back. Okay, in my opinion, once you get drawing these, this one's the easiest of the three. It's just like straight line. Da-dun. Okay, now what you notice if you did it well, I didn't exactly do it great. This is where straight edges are helpful. They intersect at a point. These all should intersect at a point. Okay. Okay. This intersection point, is the top of the image. The intersection point is the top of the image. Okay, so the point of intersection is the top of the image. So the top of the the intersection point's below the principal axis. So what this means is the image looks like that. That's the arrow. Sorry, my microphone about to die. Hopefully you can still hear this.